you're younger than 30, you might think this next segment isn't for you, but I'm here to tell you that it is for you. When it comes to being a woman, there's a lot we have to put up with, including our hormones and their constant and often quick changes. For today's Treasure You segment, we've invited Dr. Jill Wagner, a very dear friend of mine, to come and help us talk through these very often jarring changes and what can happen at any time. Dr. Jill, welcome to the show.
Thank you for being here. Thank you.
You know, the last couple weeks were kind of rough for me. And it was so funny, last week I came in and I asked Stuart, our executive producer, can I talk about this? He said, no problem. But I was going through, something was happening with my hormones. And I was trying to suppress them and pretend like nothing was going on and coming here to work with a great attitude. And Stuart goes, are you okay? And I said, yeah, why? He goes, your aura seems different,
right?
And I just felt really imbalanced and weird and strange. And I don't know if it's premenopause, I don't know if it was my cycle, but whatever it was, I felt different. So talk to us about what happens with women when we're having all of these changes and emotions and feelings.
Well, it happens with all of us. I mean, you know, you start. It starts when we're teenagers. And you know, when your teenage girl hits puberty, how all of a sudden everything becomes exaggerated by, you know, 100 times and all that kind of
stuff. My world's coming to an end.
And everything.
Have no friends.
Exactly. And you think, okay, really, sweetheart? But she can't help that because her hormones are changing. And so it starts that early. And then when we hit our 20s and our late 20s and early 30s, we notice different changes. And then in our 40s. And then finally in our 50s, we hit menopause. So when we talk about hormones, though, most women only think about the changes that occur at menopause. So they don't really connect the dots and know that there's some days I'm blue or some days I'm having a migraine headache and it's right before my cycle and I don't know what's going on. And a lot of those things are hormonal changes.
So let me ask you this. When you're feeling these changes, depending on whatever age you're that you're going through, whatever the, you know, the cycle, what do you do about it?
Well, first of all, you understand that it's probably going to pass. And so then you know that this is not the end of the world. Today I'm not having a good day. I'm probably cycling through something. In a couple of days I'm going to be better. But the thing that you really have to make note of, if you're a woman that, say, you start having migraine headaches that are just really crippling migraines, and you notice that that's happening right before my cycle every time, document that. And so when you go in to talk to your doctor, you can say, look, this is new. I'm having migraine headaches. They happen 2 days before my cycle. Could it be something hormonal? Could it be something I can do? And for some women, they may need medication, prescription medication. But for a lot of women, it's simply maybe changing your lifestyle, changing what you're eating through during that time.
Sometimes the foods can affect.
The foods can definitely affect. And so sometimes changing that, sometimes picking up your exercise a little bit during that time so you release more endorphins. I mean, there's just a lot of things you can do, but first you have to be able to target when the problem is so you can talk to your doctor about it and really get some good guidance.
So what about with menopause? Because that typically is when, I mean,
everything goes crazy.
That's what I'm hearing, right?
Everything goes, you know, for years, way back when, first of all, women didn't live, you know, in the 1900s, they lived to be about 52, you know, so most women didn't really go through menopause because they died before,
before
it got
that.
But then if a woman lived long enough to be menopausal, they thought that she had lost her mind. And so women ended up in sanitariums because they were going through these really weird changes.
And nobody understood why.
Nobody understood why. And when we're talking about menopause, we only talk about hot flashes.
So I know my mother used to always have those.
And that,
because, and I didn't understand. I'm having these hot flashes.
And that's the only thing. But we don't talk about the insomnia, which is huge. We don't talk about the anxiety. We don't talk about the depression. So a lot of women get these other changes and the mood swings. And when I'm talking about mood swings, I'm not talking about just not feeling good today. I'm talking about standing in the grocery store, trying not to knock a patch of hair out of the, you know, the little girl's head. You know, I'm talking about these mood swings.
Yeah, it's like I'm about to lose my mind and go off.
Why am I so crazy? What is it? Or you're yelling at your husband and you know something. It's just somebody over there.
They're totally getting it over there.
Right. So you know that something is really wrong,
right,
and something that you have to do something about because it's interfering with your life.
And so tell us some of the things that are available now for women.
Okay.
Because I think there's so many more options than when my mother
there
was going through
are.
It.
And the first thing that happened back in 2002, when the Women's Health Initiative came out and said a hormone replacement therapy causes cancer. Every woman stopped and was scared to death.
Yes.
And so, you know, everybody stopped and stood in their tracks. What I want to say to women is that's been 10 years.
Yeah.
And in 10 years, there's been a lot of research that has occurred. We haven't talked about it as much as we talked about that because that was so, you know, was such a big deal.
Right.
But there's been a lot of little progress made since then.
Okay.
So there, we know that you can do hormone replacement therapy and do it in a safe way. That's one thing.
Okay.
The other thing is we also know that there are some herbal products and some vitamins and supplements and things that you can do that will help you to be able to transition very good. And also with everything, I don't care if you're 21 and you're having PMS or you're 51 and you're going through menopause, lifestyle is critical.
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 Okay. We're going to be back in a minute. We got some more to talk to you about and one of your patients that we're going to actually speak to.
Okay.
And if you would like to meet Dr. Jill and attend her hormone seminar, I recommend that you all go because I promise you it will be amazing and very informative. It's coming up at the end of June. It's at 1801 East Wheatland Road in Dallas, begins at 9 a.m. For more information, head to Hormone Harmony, number 4, number 4u.com, right?
Hormone Harmony, 4u.com.